No. Testing. Testing. Create a dashboard. Oh. My Twitch key didn't work. Hang on. Create a dashboard. Yes, we have, Trish. We have started indeed. Okay, guys. Welcome. Do me a favor, post the Twitch link on Facebook and Telegram, yeah? Okay. And also, one of you. Check the audio first. Just quick audio check. Music wise, levels. It's twitch.tv/breakfreetrading. But test the audio first. One of you go to the stream. Uh-huh. Cut myself in pieces. I got infinite little secrets. Scattered brains to come in the refrain. Is that our music?
Yeah,
oh, that's your music. So do you hear me? There should be some background music.
It's good.
Sounds good. Alright.
I love it.
Muted.
Sounds good.
Alright. Let's get that out to the people. People are hungry. Okay. Let's just wait for everyone to tune in. Alright. Welcome. Welcome everyone. Feel free to post a message in the chat.
Is anyone in?
Yeah, we got a couple of people tuning in. We're waiting for everyone to just before we start, just so we can
to say hi.
Yeah, that's Anton.
What's up, everyone?
All right,
good.
That is good. Okay. Feel free to post some comments so we can see your, well, you know, like chat, like just say who you are and so on. Always takes a little time for everyone to tune in, but in about 5 minutes, I think we'll start for real. So that leaves you time to make popcorn and get like a drink. And on my left side, I have Starbucks, and I kind of promised today that we're gonna talk about futures products, stocks, CFDs. Nothing about Forex, and that should be a little exciting. because it is definitely different.
Okay.
Okay. Let's see. So I actually have trading view here on my right side. They have markets available up here where you can select the different kind of products you wanna look into, and then they actually have some really good overviews on which markets are moving right now. So there's always something to trade, there's always something to find. The question is whether you should be trading it. Or you can't trade it if you have access to it. And is that funny, guys?
No, I'm laughing at
you. Okay.
I'm not laughing at you.
Oh, okay, I see. Alright. And we just have a bunch of different instruments available to us. But again, the real question is, do you have access to it or not? Most of the times the large cap markets we have access to. Let me see. So you can see Starbucks here actually provided like a really nice signal. Trisha, can you be quiet? Thank you. Okay. Top gainers. And some of these movements are just like, you know, you have some of these that will move 90% in a day. This is like, let's see what's going on. CNST Constellation Pharmaceuticals or something like that. I have no idea what this is. This is not really something I would trade either. There's no historical data. There's nothing really here to see. Sure, you can trade this if you want, but it will mostly just be, you know, about luck if you don't know what you're doing when it comes to these. And please, guys out there sitting there watching now, let me know how's the audio. If you're on a different music playlist or just whatever in general. Also, you have these in trading, you have this market movers, you have top losers. And yeah, some of them are really getting punched. Strong sells, that's all. Alright, we'll start in 2 minutes. I'll start on offloading information. I'm not sure they're waiting for the information.
I think this information is too valuable.
So Microsoft, like, it's a very messy chart, nothing to do here really. 15 viewers. Yeah, we're recording it, we'll upload it separately. Okay. Alright, well thanks, it will be just a moment before we start. Just want to make sure we get everyone gathered in the build first of all. Again, feel free to chat if you want. I'm just gonna look through some of this.
So
Berkshire Hathaway.
What's gonna be the agenda of this video? What is?
We are talking today about futures products, and that includes CFDs on stocks. Includes futures on like all products, just in general, mm-hmm. like this entire genre of markets that we haven't really been exploring very much.
Mm. Okay, so after Asger is going to share about the futures and the options and everything, we're also going to have one announcement, and it's going to be about the product. So it's going to be an exciting one. So just stay on the stream till the end, and we're going to announce it as well.
Yeah. Adobe. What is Adobe doing? Moving up like everything else.
Darkest times, you're all good.
That's such a messed up chart. Look at those swings. I mean, you can almost just guess what comes next here. It's another spike down. Okay, guys, let's begin this show. So, I was requested to talk about CFDs, futures, and the whole thing today. So we're just gonna go through this, and you guys can ask questions as we go along, right? So, what you have to understand, first of all, is just like the current state of the equity market in the US, okay? So, and not just the US, this is really about the world, like how equities are looking right now. And it's turning everything off here just so we can get a view, okay? So this is the Dow Jones Index. And it goes, you know, all the way back to, I think it's 1930s. We have it all the way to 1915. And you can kind of see how this has just been one massive industry, really. Just it's really more about humanity and how technology has and civilization has just arisen. So where we find ourselves now is all the way up here. And if you look in the past history, it's not uncommon for the market to do these wild moves up for years. It can be years before you don't have like a total dump, like a complete devastation of the markets. Now today in the world markets, when people are trading this, we do have breakers, circuit breakers, which make sure that we don't see what we saw back in, I think it was called Black Monday in 1930s, where it just took a massive dump in one day. So what happens now is that if the market is, you know, if a stock or the index is moving more than a certain percentage in one day, the exchange will halt the transactions, which means that there will be a pause in the market, a chance for the panic to settle. It's also a chance for liquidity to come in. It's really to make sure that we don't see these massive falls. But that doesn't mean that economies can collapse entirely. So what we're finding ourselves right now is here in, let's see, we have 2008. Everyone talks about 2008 as the last financial crisis. And you can kind of see how we have recovered at this point to all the way up here. So we are vastly higher up than we ever were in 2008. And it is a pretty dangerous situation if you ask me, simply because what happened in 2008 wasn't never really fixed. Like the problems that made this happen was never really solved. We kind of just swept it under the rug and was like, we'll come back to this and fix it. And here we are 10 years later and it's still the same thing going. What I'm talking about is the balance sheet. I'm talking about how money has been being printed out of the air, and it goes to the bank. Money's being printed, it goes to the bank loans it out, and the money goes back into equities or other market products, instruments, and just used to buy. Okay, so what this means is that we are in we're about to start maybe the craziest bull run that equities have seen ever. And if you want to compare this to something, you should compare to what happened in 2017, in the last quarter of 2017, when we had, you know, the crypto bubble. And it is a complete phase where all logic and rationality goes out the window, and there's only one direction, that's up. So if anything is, so if we have an entire market that's moving up, and then we have outliers, meaning specific stocks that is not moving along everything else, that tells you something is very wrong with those. Because when you have a bull market, everything and anything that can be bought will move up. So if they're not moving along with everything else, something is wrong with them. And I would rather not buy them. So that's why, guys, when we're going into a market like this, instead of looking for short opportunities, what we really want to look for is long opportunities. There's absolutely no reason for us, if 90% of the market is moving up, then we are looking for 90% dips. There's absolutely no reason for us to go against the stream. Have no interest in that, not if we want to make money in this. So, because of where we are and what we probably are about to see, which is like a massive leg up, like you saw here in 2007, you had this final leg up, which lasted about, I guess it's about a year that lasted. That could very easily happen here. Like we could very easily see something, and even much more extreme, because the people who are supposed to control this and make sure that this doesn't run out of control, they have kind of given up at this point. They know it's messed up. Absolutely, there's no doubt about this. They know it's messed up. The president is in on it, and he's gonna pump this as much as possible. Donald Trump absolutely has a handle on this, and it's also part of because he wants the election to be won. So he wants everyone to make great gains, and he measures his own performance by the stock index. So whether this is a good or a bad thing, it is happening, and whether we like it or not, this is happening. So that's how we look. That's how you should relate to it. Okay, so we know this is gonna go up. So if we know this is gonna go up, we're gonna look for long opportunities. So how do we use the Breakfree Trading algorithm to look for long opportunities? Well, we kind of do it like the same way we do in Forex. We turn it on and we just start scanning for trades. Now, in the stock market, there's a bunch of different stocks. Like there's a lot. There's plenty for you to choose from. So it absolutely makes no sense not to be picky. Okay, so you need to be picky about which trades you're taking. Just if it's looking like decent, don't take it, because there's so many opportunities out there. Just keep scanning until you find something. Okay, and the way you scan, you go to Trading View, you click markets, and then you go to stocks, for example, and then you just start looking through. Yeah, we'll be saving this stream. Don't worry, it's being recorded. It will be uploaded as well. So you go to Trading View, you go to stocks. And then you just start working your way through those. And what I like to start with is also always the large caps, the big companies, simply because they have more liquidity. I have absolutely zero interest in low liquidity shit stocks, because they're much more likely to be manipulated and they're much more likely to cause a loss. And they also, sure, they're also much more likely to cause a win, but it's much more of a gamble than if we're analyzing real market movers, things that actually real stocks. So you have this in front of you, and there's a tons of different ways for you to go in here and find your own little variation of which stocks you like. But you don't have to make it that complicated, really. You really just start from the very top. So in my opinion, I just start with Apple, and I'm just having a look. What is Apple doing? Well, it's just going straight up, literally straight up. Like that is just incredible, right? So if we look at this curve, that is the start of a parabolic movement. And whether it already seen the top, I don't know. But this is what it looks like when something starts going parabolic. You just don't want to short this at any time. There's just absolutely no reason for you to think in short terms here. And it's so crucial to understand this, because this is like the number one reason that people make. They're like, oh, fuck, I didn't, they get greedy because they did not get an entry here. They didn't get to buy Apple at 150 or 175, even 200 or 225. So they get greedy because they're like, if it goes up, it must come back down. But there's absolutely no limit to how much this can go up before it starts coming down. Apple could go to 500. Yes, it would be insane. And yes, if you had any short position in it, it will squeeze you out. Okay, so this is not the time to look for shorts. This is only the time to look for long opportunities. So if the trading algorithm is giving you a long opportunity, let's have a look. It is. I'm getting a long opportunity. The mindset to have in this situation is very simple. It's very simple. When it comes to trading, we think in a very simple term. If and only if the market comes down to, what is this, 235, only if the market comes down to this will I buy Apple. I'm not gonna start chasing it up here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put in a order for Apple. I'm gonna say, this is like going fishing, okay? This is like going fishing. I'm gonna say, if Apple in any circumstances comes down to 235, I will be there to catch it. This could happen overnight because of some, I don't know, maybe some faulty mistake in the production, which causes the phone to, I don't know, disconnect when you're holding it wrong. It happened before. Whatever it is, the reason, the mindset you need to have is just that if this market comes back down here, I will be buying it. And I'll be buying at 235. So you're going to put in the order and you're going to go ahead and make a separate watch list. create a new list. We're gonna call this stocks, bullish stocks, okay? We're gonna put it in here, and then I'm gonna add Apple here. So I'm keeping a track of this because I'm now putting Apple in my inventory of stocks that I'd like to buy. So I'm gonna buy this, and guess what I'm gonna do next? I'm gonna go find Microsoft. I'm gonna have a look at Microsoft. There's no trades here. Good, I'm gonna go to the next stock. I'm gonna go to Google. I'm gonna start having a look at Google, and there's no trade here either. There might not be a trade today, maybe it will show up tomorrow instead, but for now, there's nothing here. So I'm gonna go have a look at Amazon. What is Amazon doing? It's recommending me a short. It's actually a pretty nice one, which I could have taken, but honestly, I don't really have much interest in short positions at this point. It's just, I would much rather go find more stocks to go long on. What I am gonna keep in mind that Amazon is looking like this, okay? So if I do get entries down the line on tech stocks, that would be nothing smarter than also getting some short exposure. But I'm not gonna start out with short exposure, okay? So we're gonna come back to Amazon. Let's have a look. How about Facebook? I heard Facebook was going up quite a bit. And there we have it, another situation where we have a chance to long. So in the case, and only in the case of Facebook going to 187.5, will I be buying Facebook. And all I need, guys, I just need to get lucky on one of these falling, you know, having a big dip or something like that. So I'm just gonna put this trade in exactly like I'm doing with Forex. And I'm just gonna pray that someone panics and they're gonna fill me up. I'm gonna panic that someone else, I'm gonna pray that someone else is panicking enough to fill up my positions. So I'm gonna go ahead and add Facebook here to my bullish stocks. And we're gonna keep going. So what else do we have? We have JP Morgan and Chase. And again, you can kind of see how this is just an, yeah, very bullish territory. I'm not really being presented with a trade here, so that's fine. And this is how it goes, guys. And this is why the strategy that we use can be applied to all markets. By using this trading strategy, we are already filtering out so many things that people make mistakes in trading. And if you're a brand new trader and you never traded before, it can be very hard for you to imagine what's actually going on out there in the market. But the number of mistakes that people make when it comes to trading is so high, and it's stupid mistakes. It's, you know, it's human error when it comes down to it. It is psychological errors that they make because they don't really have a framework to work from. We have a very clear framework. We have our trading is built around, if something happens, then we'll execute. We have a plan already predefined. And as long as you're trading this way and you don't fall into that bracket that everyone else is trading in, like 90% of the market is trading in, where they're just, you know, they're chasing markets, they see something is going up, or they hear a rumor, or they're buying on any of this that's without a plan. As long as we don't engage in any of these activities, we'll be perfectly fine, and we'll make money for years to come, 100%. Even in 5 years, when this market topples, if it takes 5 years and we start to go down, we will still be making money on just continue to use our strategy that works. And the strategy is very simple. We look at what's happening, and then we wait for someone to panic, and we use their liquidations or their panic to fill us up, to get our entry, okay? We are trading on other people's emotion. We are praying that other people will make mistakes, and they will, because they do it day in and day out. So as long as we don't engage in that, we'll be perfectly fine. So Johnson & Johnson. This was before the stock market was starting to go crazy. I actually did short Johnson & Johnson with a buddy up here on this huge fall. I remember this. This was about, they found out that there was some really bad stuff in some of their baby powder that we're providing, and that cut their, that caused a massive dump. What was that? That was a 18% dump. Huge. I'm actually getting a short signal here as well. And this is interesting because this is not a, it's not a tech stocks. This is interesting to keep in mind. These short opportunities are definitely out there, but But simply because that the trend is up, I'd much rather continue down my list and see what else we have. What about Walmart? What is Walmart doing? Walmart is just moving up massively, like everything else, just going up. Just buy it. Keep buying this. At some point we're gonna be wrong about buying these stocks. At one point we'll be wrong buying these stocks because the market will turn over and we'll slowly start to see a bear market begin. But we don't know when it's gonna happen. It could be in a week, it could be in a month, it could be in 5 months, 5 years. We don't know. But I guarantee you this. The strategy of continuing to buy the trend, continuing to trade the trend, is much more profitable than trying to time the market. And what that really means is that we can be right so many times taking a trade, and then sometimes we will get kicked out of the trade because we simply were wrong at a time. But it's much more profitable than trying to do it the other way around. And it just doesn't work trying to work against the trend. And because we have the trading algorithm, it's giving us like a very good framework for telling us when we should go long and when we should go short. A lot of people mess this up, like this very basic thing of when, which direction you should trade. And their fault is our, their mistake is our profit. And that's how it works in trading. Whenever we make money, someone else is losing. Nothing on Walmart. Let's have a look. Let's go look at something else. How about Cisco? Punished. Nothing to do here. HSBC. Okay, that's very messy with a lot of gaps. In general, when it comes to futures product, sometimes you will see markets like this where you just have a bunch of gaps. It's really like a sign of liquidity missing in the market, and that means I don't really have a lot of interest in trading it. You can try to trade it, but I prefer honestly to stay away from these. Again, we can, when it comes to the stock market, we can afford to be picky because there's so much to choose from. There's so much to choose from here, right? So let's go have a look at some of the things that moved today. And I would go have a look at the top losers. Let's have a look. Top losers. And I'm not interested in like minus 50%, minus 40, 30%. So I'm not interested in those. What I'm looking for is something in the range of minus 1 to like minus 10% top, right? And then I'm looking for something with high liquidity. And how do I know if it has high liquidity? Well, first, the first way is really looking at the market cap. How big a market cap does it have, right? How big of a company are we working with here? Next thing occurs about is the volume, really. So let's have a look. Any of these are really fine. Like this, these are all fine market caps. I would say anything above 10 billion is fine. So these are all, these will all make it. So if we have a look, let's see. Hang on a second. Change. So if we have a look at, what is that? Walgreens Boots Alliance. VBA. WBBA. Let's have a look. There's nothing here. SLB. Probably be a fine short. What is Uber doing these days? Not enough data here for us to trade this. This one I've been seeing quite a bit. Biogen, a lot of mentions about this stock. That's a big move up. That is big. Right on earnings day, up 45%. Fills this gap. Well, actually, is that a double gap? That is a double gap. That is crazy. Okay. Nothing to do. Have a look, see if we can find. So you can actually go here and usually you can customize Actually, there's a way to customize these. Okay, let's go look at some futures products instead. So, when it comes to futures, again, markets, and then you just simply go to futures instead. And we have a bunch of different stuff, okay? So, what are futures, right? Like, in general, what futures are, they're used in many different ways. Let me give you an example of how a future product helps the actual market, like the actual people working in the market. So if you have something like corn futures, okay, if you have something like corn futures, the way that farmers might use this product, this trading instrument, is that a lot of farmers will be able to say that the next, they will be able to say the next harvest next year will be worse than the one they had this year. And they'll be able to say this based on, climate conditions. They'll be able to say this based on just this, the years of experience they have, doing these crops, right? So what can you do with a future product as a farmer? Well, what a farmer is able to do is that if he knows next year that he's gonna yield about, I don't know how many tons of corn, he is actually able to go into the futures market of corn and open a short position equal to the harvest that he will make next year. If he's anticipating next year that the price will be lower than it is this year, for whatever reason, or the price will go higher this year, he's able to go into the market, open a position on the actual futures product, and hedging his own future. And that means that if he's able to accurately predict what is happening the next year with his harvest, he can either save himself a lot of money or make himself a lot of money. And this is how that farmers becomes speculative investors as well. And it happens all the time. The same way this is happening in cryptocurrency, like with Bitcoin farming. Miners in China, a lot of them were able to, well, not a lot of them, but those with sense at least, were able to, back in 2017 during the bubble, they were able to say, well, for the next year, we're gonna mine X amount of Bitcoins. They knew they're gonna mine, let's say they're gonna mine 100 Bitcoins over the time of a year. That's a decent sized operation, okay? And if they were able to do that, they could simply go into BitMEX or Coinbase or someone with a future product on Bitcoin and basically hedge the future result. And what this allows them to do is, build a much more stable, position in the industry. So different industries have these future products, which basically indicate the future of the product they're working with. And using those, they are able to hedge their future results. And this helps them provide more stability to the economic situation, right? So when we have all these, we have even like live cattle futures, lumber futures, wheat, coffee, feeder cattle. I guess that's feeding for cattle, and oat, rice, soybean, wheat, and a lot of these products is really being traded by a lot of old school traders, people who used to trade in the old days, because these are some of the first products that came out. This is how trade started in the first place. People had wheat. That's what people used to, before money even existed, they used to trade with this. They had a certain amount of wheat, and they said, how many sheep will you give me for this 1 ton of wheat? So that's, I know, that's how markets were created. And eventually they found their way to an exchange. And today, 50 years later, 70 years later, we can now use it to our advantage. So if we have something like, let's say, soybean. I know Anton loves soybean. And soybean futures, right? So we go have a look at soybean futures. current contract. So if you, when you, whenever you go to TradingView and you look at futures, it will come up like a category like this. Whenever this is, just select this one. Continuous current contract in the front. And then you just simply go have a look. So that's actually pretty wild. It's not too bad. So since May 2019, soybean has actually increased 20% in value. That's quite a bit, 20% in about 6 months. So that's definitely something you can trade. And there's not really any trade for us to take here. So let's go have a look at wheat futures. And here we have it. And it's the same thing, guys, as we always do. Now, a lot of people are confused about, like, should I put in an order when a market is really far away from that entry? Should I put in an order? The answer is yes, absolutely you should do that. And there's a couple of reasons for this. The first reason is that you might get lucky and there's a quick panic in the market. And if you're just buying the support of whatever market it is, and you just keep doing this, you will make consistent profit doing this, 100%. So a lot of times I really like planning these trades ahead like this, like just saying, well, in the case that wheat futures comes down to, what is that? That's 500. I will be buying the crap out of it, because I know I will be able to offload this. Maybe not during the first day of the panic, but the second day or the third day after the panic was there, I will be able to offload this for a profit, 100%. Sugar futures. So these are just like an example of some of the markets out there. And these are also available on IC markets. So here's actually a long position available. And honestly, this is a quick trade. That's a quick setup you have right there. That's not gonna take too long to complete. And it looks great. This looks like a great trade. Why do I like this trade? Well, I like the push through here. And then I like the test. I like this test that comes back down here where the buyers showed up again. And then they tried to push it up again. And you can kind of see how this is how this market in general works. Like this is the typical pattern in this market. You have this push up, push down, push up, push down. And that's just the normal market, right? So there's plenty of opportunity for us to trade here. So putting in this trade with 5% risk is absolutely a good trade to take, right? Let's see, like that. That's a great trade to take. And as long as we keep taking trades like this, meaning that we keep buying support and we keep selling resistance, as long as we keep doing this, we are already ahead of the pack. We are already trading much better than 90% of the market. 90% of the market is chasing this. They see wheat, they see sugar futures going up. What is that? How much was that? That was like, let's see, wow, that's insane. That they see sugar futures up by 12% in one day and they go buy it. That's what the majority of the market is doing. That's not the right way to trade. The right way to trade is letting all those euphoric people buy first. Wait for their patience to give up, and then you buy from them, and then the market goes up. Market never goes up when everyone wants it to go up, and market never goes down when everyone wants it to go down. It typically go the opposite way of what the mass wanted to do. That's very classic for markets. So what other futures products do we have? If we go to trading view, we go to futures. Let's see. So we have crude oil, we have NASDAQ, gold futures. Let's have a look at gold futures. What is that? Looks kind of bull flaggy. Gold looks interesting. So since September, it's kind of been this consolidation. That is 100% a bull flag. I think gold people who have been buying gold are very happy with the results this year. I mean, for the past 4 years, gold has just been doing it, has just been trading in this range bound market. It hasn't really been doing anything, and people has been talking a lot about gold. And then we finally started to moving out of this phase, and now we're in a bull flag here. So I think I'm pretty confident there's going to be a signal very soon on gold. So this is something I would keep an eye on the gold futures. Let's see what else we have. We also have indexes available to us here. And a lot of these indexes are actually available to us through IC markets as well and on simple FX. Something like DAX futures, that is a highly traded product, highly liquid. I love to trade this as well. It's a great market. And again, a lot of people will be trying to short it. There will be people actively trying to short something that's going up this vertical, and it makes absolutely no reason to do it. When we have the Breakfree Trading algorithm, it's just like stepping in and telling us that's not a good idea. So again, this is very simple for me, guys. This is extremely simple. If and only if the DAX futures is coming down to 12,500, will I be taking this trade? I think it's starting to get the idea. And it sounds so simple. It sounds so simple how this works that we're just saying, well, in the case it comes down, we'll buy it. But the majority of the market is simply not doing this. And this is all you have to do in the world to be a profitable trader, is to have some good levels and just buy it. And most people just can't do it. They really can't do this. Okay, so this is the secret. I like to stay away from illiquid products. I like to stay away from products which has huge gaps in between the close and open. So that's why futures products are good to trade for us. When it comes to stocks, like if I have to choose between if I want to trade stocks or I want to trade futures products, I'd much rather go with futures products, because futures, they also don't close every day. You know, the stock market is only open for 8 hours a day, roughly, right? So futures are running just like Forex from Monday. Actually, I think it's even like Sunday night or something like that until Friday night. So there's plenty of opportunity there. Now, if you have questions out there, feel free to bring them, because I'll just keep talking. So feel free to just step in if you have any questions. And let me know, Trisha, if there's any questions, yeah? And I don't see them. So, it's just mad.
Would you like to answer questions from Aviani?
Sure, what's the question?
The question is, do trades get deleted when you think too long to hit?
So, that's a good question. That's okay. Okay, so I'll answer this first. After a certain time, I would say like after a week, you can go ahead and delete the trade if it hasn't hit. After a week. Okay. Now, I see a chat question here. I had two trades of mine, and as soon as they hit the trade, they disappeared. This is actually okay. Now, it's not ideal. I would like that to be different. However, there's simply some... We're not even supposed to be able to do this thing that we're doing right now in TradingView. And there's simply some things that is this way. And that's why we have to mark out these trades, because this is something that happens. You put in a trade and then it might be gone the next day. It does not mean that the trade is invalid. Not at all. And it doesn't mean that it's not a good trade to take. It just means that the market structure has changed. And it doesn't mean that it's worse or better. I know that's a bit confusing. So what you need to do, and this is why every time I'm doing these trades, like here for example, if I had to take this trade on DAX futures, it would look something like this. Hang on. Right? And then we use the horizontal line tool and you just mark them out. And this is why we do this. Oh, that's the wrong horizontal line tool. Here we go. So that's why we mark them out like this. Simply because that the way TradingView is constructed and the way that we have built this into TradingView is not really meant to be. There's advanced calculations in TradingView, like we can do very advanced calculations. However, actually doing a graphical output on the platform is extremely difficult. But I understand the confusion. Now, here's the thing, guys. And we're pretty excited about this. We're building our own trading platform, because right now, yes, four lines instead of two. Four lines instead of two. So here's the thing. We're building our own trading platform, because right now what we're using is that, you know, we have our broker, which is separate, either SimpleFX, IC Markets, or maybe something else. And then we're using TradingView, we're also using MetaTrader, and we're using the position calculator. It's like four tools on four different platforms. And it's not, that's not really like a user-friendly experience in my opinion. It's not as good as it could be. So what we're working on right now, we're basically creating our own TradingView platform, and it's gonna have built-in position calculator. It's gonna have built-in risk-reward ratio. It's gonna have a built-in trading algorithm. All of this will be in, you're welcome, man. I made 80% off my first trade. Well, I'm happy for you. That's great. honestly, I can say myself, this has been kind of a rough week for me, trading wise with the algorithm. And one thing I wanna turn to here, which is very important, is that in trading, you're gonna have some rough times. There will be a week where you're not making any money or even losing money. Now, this is perfectly fine. Of course, it's not the result we want, but you have to understand, this is just a part of trading. Anyone who tells you differently are lying. It's simply not true. There will be times where it's just not working in our favor. However, the only thing we can do is consistently putting out trades using the same trading framework that generated profit for us before. So, I'm happy for you too, man. Spunky Peak 1, congrats on the $80. $80 is a lot of money. And it's so important that whenever we are facing these situations, you have to understand, most people, when they are in a situation where they're losing money, what happens to people usually, and this, you probably recognize this from playing poker or going to a casino. What happens is that you go into the casino and you'll maybe go in and say with, let's say you're going with $500, right? And then you buy in at a poker table, or you go to the roulette and you're like, all right, that's, you know, we're going to start out fun. So you put in $50 and maybe you make a little bit of that. Maybe you increase your casino account size to $600 or $700, right? Things are good. You're happy. You're making money. Everything is good. Then after some time, things are starting to turn differently. Maybe you changed your strategy. Maybe you're not doing what you did before. Maybe you increased your risk or whatever it is. And what happens next is that you start losing money. And at a certain point, and usually it's about when people have lost about 50% of their capital. And this is whether it's trading or it's in a casino. Typically, when people have lost about 50% of the capital, they start getting very negative. They start getting extremely negative about what's happening because they're like, oh, that's really not what they wanted. So when they start getting negative, they start doing what's called revenge trading or revenge gambling, whatever you want to call it. And that means that they're like, okay, I need to win back what I lost. And what they do next is that they start gambling in ways that's just entirely inappropriate. That's not going to get them back to what they want. And after they go from that 50% drawdown and they come down to what's 80% drawdown, they turn to this mindset where they're like, you know what? It doesn't even matter anymore. I'm just going to go all in, right? So they go through this roller coaster ride where they start out, it's kind of good. They go up, they're making money, and then they take this roller coaster down. And because they're not equipped to mentally handle what is happening in that situation where they're starting to lose money, because they're not mentally equipped to do that, the chances of them recovering are so small. And when it comes to trading, this is the exact same thing. You know, when people are playing poker, they're like, oh, fuck it, just all in then. And sometimes they win and they get back into the game. But the fact that they already came to that point where they're like all in just means maybe they survive this time, but they're not going to survive next time. So what I'm trying to say here is that the way that you handle losses when it comes to trading tells everything about your character and tells everything about your trading methodology. So for me, I think if I open up my trading account right now, it will be roughly at $7,000. And I've been about this 7,000. Let's see, have a look. Maybe it's even lower. let's see. So let me see if I can pull up my IC Markets account. So this has been a bad week for me, but I'm not really losing big money here. Those gains that I'm making is being equalized into losses by some trades that's just happening to loss. And we will lose about 30% of our trades, sometimes 40% of the trades. That's perfectly okay to lose these trades. We could lose 50% of our trades. We could lose even 60% of our trades and still be profitable and use this trading strategy. Simply because that when we are right, we are right big. And when we're wrong small. And that's how it works in trading. So I'm still loading IC Markets over here. But the point is that, yes, I'm not, this week has not been as I wish it was. I would have liked to have been much closer to $8,000. And I was this morning. And then the market turned around. And this happens all the time. So for someone new who comes into this and they see that, that might be very difficult for them to handle. I'm not really loading IC Markets. It's not really working. So the point is, guys, when things are not going in your favor, it is very important that you have a strategy and make sure that you don't go into this degenerate gambler mindset, which people do in the casinos. It's very important that you protect your capital. Protecting capital is much more important than making gains. The way that you keep your money safe is much more important than the way you make money, because it's just the way that it works long term for you to really compound an account into profit. So it can take some time when you have these bad weeks or something like that. There's nothing wrong with that. Now I see we have another question. Basic question. Having 20 trades on 5% risk each means that my whole account volume is put on risk. And Asker, I guess that's my name, Asker once said he would like to milk his account every now and then in order to get money from the broker's account to his private account. Isn't the bigger account the better? Very basic question. Okay. Alright, if you guys want to see that question, you can go read in the chat. I'm not sure how good a job I did of reading it out loud. As you know, my English skills are not that good. Oh, thanks, Trisha. Alright. Yes, if you do 20 trades, so if we have an account, let's say $10,000, and we do 10, you set up 10 trades, all 10 trades are based on 5% risk. Oh, it looks like it's loading now. We'll get back to this. All 10 trades are at 5% risk. Yes, if you lose all 10 trades, you will lose 50% of your account. That's correct. But if you do another 10 trades after this, you will lose 50% of your account again, but it's not going to be your entire account. First time it was from $10,000 to $5,000. Next one would be from $5,000 to $2,500. But the way you should be doing this is that whenever you make a trade, right, you put on one trade, you're saying you're putting risking 5% of the capital, and then you might be adding another trade the day later. The day later, you'll be looking at your equity curve, and if you're down, that 5% risk will also be smaller. So isn't it better to keep my account big? Sure, there's nothing wrong with growing a big account. There's nothing wrong with that. And the bigger account you have, the more money you will make. So if you don't need the money, or you don't need to move the money around for some whatever reason, it's nothing, you don't have to withdraw money at all. But I will say, and this is just a principle that I've been working out of for a very long time. Whenever you have a trading account, and you at some point have doubled that account, meaning you're going from, you know, $5,000 to, let's say, $10,000. It's always really good, just mindset wise, and also just as a tribute to yourself, it's always good to pay yourself a little. And I like to, whenever I have a doubled account, I like to take out that doubled amount I made, just to pay myself, buy myself something. It's important. It's very important that you do this, in my opinion. So yeah, the bigger account you have, the more money you will make off these trades. So if you can do a 10K account, if you can do a 50K account, 100K account, whatever the size is for you, the more money you will make for yourself. I think like the ideal size is starting with something like $500 to $1,000. But this will equally work just fine if you're trading with $10,000 or $100,000. There's not really limitation to that. So I hope that answered the question, and feel free to have them coming in, guys, the questions. Let's have a look. Here we are. So this is pretty much how it looked last night. So I've been stuck in this 7,500 range for some time now, and it looked much different this morning. But these markets change all the time, and they will change all the time in an instant as well. I don't really worry too much about these unrealized profit. I don't worry too much about these unrealized profit. I only worry about really like the realized profit. All right, let's see. There's more questions. One of the calculations that I have to put for your position size. Well, there's a position size calculator, and there's some different things that goes into that. The price of the asset, the stops and pips, and the risk. Am I then limited by the broker to go to an amount of trades? whole account is set on risk. No, the way that leverage works, when we trade with IC Max, for example, actually this is a good example. You're seeing it's giving me a margin level of 2,500%. By nature, the way that our trades are constructed, we are either risking 1%, 2%, 3.5%, or 5% risk. Oh, you mean the lot size? So this depends. All right. I'm gonna clear this first question first. So, by the way that leverage works, that we're given leverage by the broker, and it's not really a problem to put 20 account, to put, even if you put 20 positions on a single account, it's not a problem. You can have this. I think we can have 40, I think it's something like 30 trades we can have open at the same time with 500 to 1 leverage. It really depends on the amount of leverage. And just because we have 500 to 1 leverage available doesn't mean that we are doing anything degenerate at all. It's just giving us more opportunity in the market. Like the risk management built into here is, in my opinion, extremely well and extremely fair. We're not risking too much on individual trades. We're not risking too little either. I think it's a very fair risk amount here. Like to wipe out an entire account, it's not just 20 trades. It really takes a long time to wipe out an entire account using this risk management strategy. It's hard. It's difficult. You have to lose a lot of trades in a row, a lot. And that's not really what we're doing. Now for this part, all right, so it kind of depends on your broker. So if we go, so on this account, I don't actually have access to stocks on this IC Markets account. This is purely, let's have a look. So what you're able to do is whenever you have a stock over in MetaTrader, you can right click it and you can click specifications, and then you'll be able to see the contract size. And the contract size, and let's see, the minimum, it will also show you the minimal and the maximum volume. And the minimal volume is the minimum amount you need to take. Regarding that question, I'll come back to that so we can solve that together. Now, do we manually have to close a trade in Simple FX when it gets to the target, or does it close itself? It closes itself. When it hits the TP, it closes itself. Now, if, and this is not, look, I have a framework of rules that I've given you guys that I try to work as good as well. I try to put as clear as possible. It doesn't mean that you can't make your own exceptions. It just means you shouldn't deviate from this too much. So if you're in a trade and you're watching it and it's really close to the TP, it's okay to close it yourself manually. It's just if, let me see if I can find an example. GBP New Zealand dollar, let's have a look. So this trade played out very well. So if we bought here and the target was, and the target is like sitting here, a little bit below the TP1, it's okay for you to close one or two of them. Always pay yourself. Always pay yourself, guys. It's so important that we take home money on each trade. That's why we have the TP1. It is to make sure that we always get paid, even if the trade comes back in our face and we get out, we have still made some money. And this, not only does it help you with your mindset that, oh, you didn't lose all the money that was open in that trade, not only does it help with that, but it literally boosts your account. And these small compounded results from TP1, they will build up and they will make up your account much more than you will even believe. So it's very important, always pay yourself. So we're always making money in trading. It's very important. Of course we're gonna have losses, that's the cost of doing business. But when we have a winning trade, instead of just hoping, you know, instead of just hoping that it's gonna go straight to TP1, the final target, we're gonna pay ourselves. because we don't know what's gonna happen. All right, keep the questions coming, guys. Keep the questions coming, guys. When we run out of questions, is when we stop. And we have a small thing we want to talk about today. So let's see. So, GBP New Zealand dollar right here, right now. Let's have a look. So I think it actually hit. Did it hit TP1? I mean TP2? Well, first of all, let's delete all this. So what we have here is a class A example of a bull flag. And bull flags, you know, they always break up. That's not true. That's not true at all. But for the most part, bull flags break up. What are my thoughts on leverage? When would you recommend someone to use it? There's a lot of different ways to use leverage. A lot of different ways to use leverage. So, when would I recommend people to use leverage? I would recommend people to use leverage with the Breakfree Trading algorithm, because for the most part, when people have leverage available to them, they can't really control it. It often ends in a bad way. It often ends in the wrong result. So the right way to use leverage is not to max out your leverage. The right way to use, you know, on a single position, the right way to use leverage is to use it to give yourself the opportunity to place positions in the market without exposing yourself across your risk matrix, right? So the reason that we signed on for 500 to 1 leverage in IC markets, it's simply because that it allows us to take a lot more position while keeping our risk managed. And that really allows us to be able to take all these different positions without really overextending ourselves on these markets. So that means whenever we are trading a product, we will be able to go out and find a hedge for that same trade and without filling out our account. So if we're only using 100 to 1 leverage, we might only be able to take, I guess you only be able to take about 8 trades. However, when we have something like 500 to 1 leverage available to us, we are able to take up to 20, 30 trades. But because that we're risking our limits every time we are using the position calculator, and we're using our risk management built into the trading algorithm, you know, whether it's 3.5% or 5% risk, we're using this risk management matrix to make sure that we don't overextend ourselves on a single trade. That's why it's so important that we are not trading correlated markets. All right, come back. What was the question? Please don't forget to come back to the question about the limitation of the number of trades. Well, I think I covered this. So Welt, you should do so. If you traded before, you might have some experience with margin calls and so on, but you should not face those issues at all as long as you're just following my position strategy, like position size strategy. You should not be faced with this problem at all. Like, it's not, if you're limited by your broker of how many trades you're allowed open, then either your broker sucks or your position size is incorrect. If this is a problem, just get back to me or talk to Trish and we'll have a look at it. So, how are you usually reading charts and deciding what's a better trade than another? I didn't understand the liquidity definition, and I also understand long trades are better, but what about reading things like bullish flags? Okay. Sorry guys, these questions are kind of coming on top of each other. I'm just gonna clear this out with the leverage first, so we have understood each other. So $500, I'm trading with 50-to-1 leverage. Do I still trade the same way I would without leverage? We never trade without leverage. The way this trading strategy is built is always with leverage. That's how it is. Or would I have to put a small amount of my account? So if you have $500 and you have, I'm not sure if you meant 500-to-1 or 50-to-1, but it's a big difference. If you only have 50-to-1 leverage available to you, it just means that you're able to take less trades. You're not allowed the same amount of trades open. But if you're trading on simple FX or IC markets, you should have 500-to-1 leverage available. If you're in the US, you might only have 50 or 100 leverage available to you. And that means you will be limited by your broker of how many trades you can take. That does not mean, what should I say? It does not mean what is wrong. It just means that the leverage available to you will not allow you to take further position. But this, I doubt this is a problem. I doubt you being limited by a broker this way. And if you are, let's see if we can fix it. Okay, just come to the group chat or whatever and we'll solve that. So how do I usually decide what is a better trade than another? Sure, that's a good question. And I cover it every time that I'm doing this. Let me see. And I want you guys to understand that the amount of hours that I've been looking at these patterns, these markets, these candles, it's just a lot. Like, I've really been studying this a lot, and it's really just about how I've seen markets unfold, like how I've seen price action unfold. I've been studying like 1 minute charts for days, months, probably 5 minute charts, 15 minute chart, 1 hour chart. And the common denominator for all these different time frames is that it's the same thing happening on all these different charts. Now, if you're looking at, I would say if you're looking at 1 minute time frame, it's hard to get the picture, the big picture of what's going on. But if you're looking at something like 15 minutes, let's go have a look at 15 minutes, you can better get an idea of what's really going on. So we know that, we know this is in a bull flag right now. And we just had a big drop down here. So we know it's flagging. And just based on my experience, I'm so lucky, I'm gonna close IC markets here. That's better. So you see the structure here. This is the exact same structure we just saw on 4 hour, right? It's just compressed into much smaller candles. And because I know it's in a bull flag, I know that it's very likely that this is gonna break up. It can also break down, but it's more likely it's gonna break up. And overall, that's a mosquito. Overall, I know this is a market moving up right now. You can see the structure. So how I decide whether it's good or bad, it is difficult for me to put this through to you guys, simply because that this is something that's called price action. And price action is so dependent on the amount of hours that you spend looking at charts. If you haven't been looking at charts, you haven't seen how patterns develop on 1 minute time frame, on 15 minute time frame, 1 hour and so on. Until you start understanding and seeing like this actually happen, which is something you learn when you day trade a lot, it is hard to just jump straight into a chart and being able to recognize this. And that is why, yes, of course, I have an advantage over you guys, because I've been doing this so long. It's only fair that I do. But that does not mean that you can't do this. It just means that you need more time to practice this. So how do I decide whether it's a good trade or not? Well, yesterday I turned on the algorithm. I think it was yesterday. Or was it 2 days ago? And I guess it was Monday, the 1st November. And I saw it come down here, and already back then, I already saw it was flagging. So I just saw there was a signal on the algorithm that if it came down here, I would buy it, right? And simply because that this structure that it presented itself looked like a flag, I knew that this was a good trade to take. So I took it and I closed it in profit. And that's about it. So we had CAD CHF. Like, I'm also wrong from time to time. It happens. had CHF, right? And back here, there was a, it was down here, it gave a long position. And the, what I do is, what I do is that I start to look at the market structure, right? So I go to weekly, and I'm starting to see like, what has been going on in this market for the past years? Like, what is the common thing that happens? And in a lot of markets, you know, all markets, they either go up or they go down. That's how it works in markets. They go up and they go down. But the question is, how do they go up and how do they go down? So in Canadian dollar and Swiss franc, what I noticed, what this pattern, as you can see, it is like a saw blade, right? Up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, right? So I recognize, okay, this market is moving in this very specific ways. It has been doing this since pretty much 2015. How likely is it that it's going to continue to do this? Very likely. It's very likely it's going to continue to do this. Okay, so if this market is moving in this specific way, then I also, it's giving me a hint of what is happening, right? So simply because that I saw it, and you can see it here, guys. Like you can see this, the structure of this and this, it's the same thing happening again and again, right? Sometimes it's more volatile than other times. Sometimes the drops are bigger than that other time, but it's the same thing. You have a big drop and then you have the recovery. So if we just buy the recovery every time, we'll be fine. So when I'm seeing this, this trade back here, let's see if I can pull it up. I think it looked like, okay. So when I saw this trade, it was trading down here. It hadn't unfolded like this yet. And what I looked at, here was really just like, what is happening, right? So we had to push up and we had to push down. And you can see here, last time we had to push up, we had this big wick as well. This big push up as well. And that's all I was gaming for. It's just, I'm saying, well, we had a push down. It's very likely the next thing that's gonna happen is that it's gonna push up. That's how simple it is for me. I looked at the market structure, saw this is a repeating pattern. It's probably likely it's gonna take a turn up before it goes down further. That's it. So when do I not like a trade? When is something that I don't like to see? Let's go have a look at, just something. And feel free to keep the questions coming. All right. It's looking pretty brutal. So when do I not like a trade? I was actually looking at this trade earlier today. But I have so much Australian exposure already that I'm not really that interested in Australian dollar exposure. Yeah, I understand. What does a bad trade look like? One thing is that I can explain to you and I can show you what a bad trade looks like. But the thing is, they come in so many different forms. And it's not always one thing. What's happening is that, you know, I look at the market and I look back and my, what's happening in my mind is that I'm trying to recognize like these situations playing out before. I'm trying to recognize prior trades, whether they were successful or not with this specific structure. And this is just, you know, this is like a guy playing basketball, shooting a very specific way from muscle memory. He can't pass that on to you because you haven't done the shots. You haven't done the 50,000 shots on the court like he has. So some of this you have to accept that it's going to take you some practice. And if you want to learn about it, you got to learn about price action. Okay. So again, Forex are such a tricky market to trade. So you see, I'm looking at this. I'm not going to buy this. And even if I had Australian exposure, even if I didn't have exposure on Australian dollar, I would not be taking this trade. Simply because I really don't like these setups. I really don't like when you have a big push up and then it just slowly bleeds down. Because what's happening, what's happening inside here, guys, is that people are buying all the way down. Buying all the way down here. And they're all wrong. At least this is what the market's done. They're all wrong. And what usually happens in the end is that it ends up with a liquidation cascade. That means that everyone is being forced out of position at once, and that's when you have these fall downs. So I don't like this setup particularly. What I would like is I would like to buy it down somewhere like here. But on a setup like this, it's just too similar to this. It's just happened too many times. I'd much rather go find something else too long than this one. So this is in my opinion a good example of a setup that I would just avoid. Simply because that I don't like how this price action is looking. It's looking extremely weak. It's just slowly bleeding down. It's not interesting at all for me. And yeah, it might hold, but honestly, look at it. There's no real market structure here to... Like, if you look at the way this came up, this was pushed up on extreme volume, probably. On very high volume, this was pushed up, and now it's coming down slowly. So that means when something is pushed up very fast like this, it has no time to build support. It has no time to build market structure. And that means it's very likely to just come down. So that's the trade I would avoid. Simply, and that doesn't mean the trade won't be successful. It just means that I prefer to take a different trade. You don't have to take the trades. If you have a personal bias against them, you don't have to take the trade. But do make sure that you come back and you check the trade, whether you were right or wrong to take the trade. And mark it down so you understand and you can try to remember, was that a successful trade for you or was it a bad trade for you? And just because I'm not taking this trade doesn't mean it's a bad trade. It just means I would prefer losing money on something else than this one, if I had to. All right. This is just my personal opinion, but I use 0.01 per $100. This way I don't ever overleverage. This is fine. And you're welcome to do this. But you have to remember, a lot of people, that they come to this game and they have no sense of risk management at all. They have no sense of risk management at all. What we're installing with the Breakfree Trading algorithm is a really good risk management strategy. And that is just, it's just so important to keep, like, risk management is such a big part of trading. Because a lot of people, they have this mindset when it comes to trading. They're like, they look at a trade and they feel like this trade is gonna be a winner. This trade is gonna be a winner. And then they're like, well, if they're so sure this trade is gonna be a winner, why don't I just up the position size a little bit more than last time, just a little bit more, because you know, it's probably gonna be a winner. And if there's one thing I do know, it's that whenever you have a winning trade, your position size is always too small. And whenever you have a losing trade, your position size, when you have a winner trade, the position size is too small. And when you have a losing trade, your position size is too big. Yeah, and that's extremely common to blow accounts. I've blown accounts myself. Back when I started trading, I had no idea what I was doing. I don't know how many accounts I've blown before I started understanding that it's not about the position size that you're trading. It's not about the size you're trading, it's about how you trade. It's about how you handle your risk management. It's about how you handle your mindset. Such a big part of trading. All right. We had a lot of people sign up with us this week, and it's very exciting. Now, for the announcement, guys. So, Anton.
Yeah.
Are you coming in?
Announcement time, yeah?
Yes. Alright, guys. Anton is here.
Alright, guys. So, you know, keep coming to those live streams, because the difference between a person that is successful and the person that is just, you know, getting by or just maybe successful, you know, sometimes, maybe one time a month, you know, is the knowledge, right? So, it's you always have to be informed. You always have to know what, you know, the dangers and all the tricks, you know, so just keep coming to those live streams and, you know, keep taking notes. In a few months, you're gonna be able to, you know, in a predictable way, make money with trading. And it's gonna be a different life. So it's good. But anyway, what I wanted to announce is that we have some people that maybe cannot afford the $199 membership, which is still cheap, like, guys, like, for the amount of money you can make with this algorithm, because it works in all the markets, it's pretty fucking cheap. But I understand that, because since we're promoting this to the whole world, and, you know, people come from different economic situations, you know, some of you guys are really, you know trying to find the source of income, but like, you don't have the capital yet. So how do we make it affordable for you? Yeah, so we decided that we're going to release a light version of the product where you will have the exact same functionality of the Breakfree Trading algorithm, like the full version, but we're going to limit the amount of markets that you can trade it on, so that you can try it out on how many markets?
Eight forex markets will be available to you, and it will allow you to get a bit more comfortable and see it up front how it is, and once you're ready, you can start trading more markets, right? So the idea is really like giving more people an opportunity to come in, because like, this will all, like, in, you know, a year from now, this is not gonna look like this at all. We're gonna have our own trading platform. It's gonna be an entire different story of how everything is set up, but for now, we're seeing a high interest in what we're doing, and we're very happy for that. And it sucks that we have to reject a lot of people who's asking for discounts.
Yeah.
So we want to give the opportunity to use this trading system with more markets, for more people, but also in a way that respects the people who are paying $200 a month. So we're coming out with two things. The first thing is we call it Breakfree Trading
Explore. So Discover version.
Discover.
It's going to be Breakfree Trading Discover.
Okay.
And we're going to announce it soon. Don't have an exact date yet, but basically it's going to be eight forex markets, full functionality of Breakfree Trading algorithm. And you'll be able to maybe make, you know, a couple of trades a week. Yeah. Not every week. You'll have an opportunity, but at least the price tag is going to be affordable, and we're thinking about $49 per month.
Yeah.
Guys, if you don't have $49 to invest in yourself, I guess this is just, you know, this is not a good fit.
No, and that's okay. That's okay, because sometimes you just gotta go get a job, save up money so you can,
yeah,
whatever it is you want. If you want to buy something, if you want to buy a new phone, or you want to, whenever you have to do something in life, you gotta fucking work for it. And that's how it is. Now, we've done the majority of the work, and that's why we want to give this to you. We also have another option coming out, which is really like an advanced version, and this is not going to be for a lot of people, but there's some people who has requested this, and it'll be $17.99.
All right, so there's going to be an advanced version. We don't want to talk about it just yet, guys. Like, don't want to discuss it, right? All so right. Because it's some powerful stuff. If you want to know, just hit us up. But I just want to talk about the light version, guys. If you don't have $49 to invest, and you know you went through the pains of signing up through our website, looking at the videos, you know, spending what, 4 or 3 hours trying to learn trading, right? And you can't invest $49 to really, you know, invest in yourself and find a new stream of income. I guess you're just, this is probably a limiting belief, or I don't know what's the problem.
Again, you know? like you said, starting, people coming from different places in the world.
Yeah.
But we hope this will give more people the ability to come trade with us, because the idea is that when we launch a new platform, there's also going to be a free option to trade on our platform. The idea is really we want to help people not lose money in the market like the majority of people is. So we want to help people doing this, and this is the roadmap we're on right now, and it's quite ambitious mission we have for ourselves. But we believe we can do it. And we need your help as well. And we're extremely excited to have you on board joining us here. And you are truly pioneers along with us doing this, because no one else is doing it this way. Everyone else is teaching traditional trading. And we know from a fact that whenever people are taught traditional trading and they go into the real markets, they get slayed again and again. It happens again and again. People don't stand a chance. So we want you to come with us, help us make trading accessible for more people, help people actually make money in this market. Let's see what we can do. I think we can do great things.
Because we believe that, you know, in 21st century, you know, you can make money on your smartphone. And trading is one of those things that if you really master it, the lifestyle upside is immense, because you can travel, you can trade on your tablet, iPad, phone. But because it's the very difficult, Everyone else is trying to compete with you. You know, you need to you need a better strategy.
Absolutely.
So that's what we're trying to do. We're just trying to teach you the better strategy and something that is not going to take hours of your day, just, you know, a few hours a day.
That's
and,
it.
And yeah, it's all about freedom, guys.
Yeah.
You know.
Thank you so much for coming tonight.
Thank you.
We are available in the group. Talk with us, chat with us, ask us questions, whatever it is we're here for.
Yeah. And keep posting your trades in the group. We're going to review your trades. And we got a contest. The last contest, Chris Hudson won.
We got $250. Yeah. We got another contest coming for you guys shortly. All right, that's it. You guys have a good night, okay? And thank you for coming tonight.
Peace. Happy trading.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.